I am Ray Banister. I was born in Alaska. My mother was a nurse, my dad was a doctor. We have 4,500 acres on our farm, about 1,000 acres of farm ground, and we graze the rest.
I've been doing high intensity grass management since 73.
It's sustainable production, that's what we go after. This was a highly erodible field. The cows were destroying my no-till. And so the field kept getting eroded and stuff, so we just seeded it back to grass, and we're pretty happy with what we got. Now this pasture right over here had been rested the previous year, and this spring we turned it into it for about 30 days with 170 cows, and there's about 180 acres of grass in this pasture. I graze it hard enough that I want to hurt the grass so the forbs and the legumes take off. They have a niche to take off, and they come in and they're kind of like a cover crop. They bring up that mineral from down low, they fix nitrogen, and they reproduce, giving you a lot of diversity. And then the grass is resting, it's got better root system, it's fully nourished. You can't have your community at one place all the time. It's got to cycle. I'm a system thinker. I don't say like the soils are most important, the land's the most important, the cattle are, the whole thing is important. We've been interested in conservation all our life, which the NRCS has been kind of instrumental in promoting, and they've done a real fine job.
This infiltration test, it simulates an inch, is what it is, in a 6-inch ring, and a set amount of water. Every drop that comes, you want it to go into the ground. So 14 seconds for an inch. Now we can do the second inch too. 25 seconds.
Here's the neighbor side of the fence, see the light tan soils? And here on our side of the fence is a dark brown. This is what started the research out.
So a dynamic soil property study compares the dynamic properties of soil. So those are the things that change. The water holding capacity, the organic matter, soil structure, the aggregate stability.
We had soil moisture sensors at 1 foot, 2 foot, and 3 foot intervals. And the results from that showed that the 1 foot soil profile was totally dry by June 11th. And we installed these on April 28th. The 1 foot soil profile on this management system didn't dry out until August, almost 2 months later.
One of the indicators that we like to look at is the amount of carbon dioxide that a soil will release. And what that is, it's a reflection of the microbial activity. And so on Ray's side, it was 141 parts per million. It was the amount of CO2 given off. On the neighbor's side, it was about 66 parts per million. So that's a reflection of, you know, of what's going on below ground. There's a term called organic matter. Right, and that's a really big number that's measured in the lab. And on Ray's side, it was 5.1. That's really high. I mean, comparative cropland in the area is probably in the twos.
This ground was seeded in 1956 and been hayed ever since. That intermediate wheatgrass has a lifespan of 5 years.
Most hay ground, you can see bare dirt because it's hayed every single year. It stresses that system, and so you're going to get exposed ground.
Oh, yeah.
Most people reseed hay ground 5-6 years. This has not been planted since the 50s. Yeah, let me stick it in here. You get your hand down close to that soil, and it's cool. Yeah. Today is in the 80s. Looks like it's stabilized about 65 degrees. And so at that temperature, you're not going to lose very much water to the air. So that top 6 inches is beautiful. It's got great, what we call aggregate structure, which means it can hold water, it'll cycle nutrients, feed the microbes, which will feed the grass, which will feed the cattle. It smells good too, which means it's active. There's microbes working. That gives it that nice garden smell. And that color comes from carbon.
I'll take this ball here and I'll drop it down here. And then we'll play hoop, where's the ball? Can you see it all? We've given talks from Texas up to Alberta and Saskatchewan, and given to 5 different universities. NRCS, I view them as educators and technical help. You look at all the great improvements in our soil erosion and stuff, to see the NRCS has pushed pretty heavy, and it's just a great organization.
Ray's done a good job building this system.
He's definitely a token here in our county, and his passion to share what he has gained over all these years in rangeland management is just phenomenal. 90% of the time, I think that we learn just as much or more from him than he from us.
This is probably the lowest input system I've seen. He doesn't have a lot of help. It's pretty much just him and a hired guy. And he does it with that amount of labor, and he makes it work. If more people did this in Montana, it'd be a different place.
We have found that good farming improves the ground. We get a lot more production, and it's sustainable. It produces in a drought, it produces in a too much rain, it produces when it's cold, it produces when it's hot, it produces when I'm tired.